local elite that grew up 60 today have gotten in the position that they are in on the backs of organizations like the Black Panther Party and the Black Liberation Army. And why do I say that? Why do I say that? I'm saying that to remind you of one historical fact, that if it were not for the Black Panther Party, you would have had the Patriot Act 15 years ago. The victory of the Black Panther Party was that it fostered the consolidation of white supremacy and right-wing political power in this country and the police state. They had to change the script, as pointed out in the movie. They had to change their rules. Police departments in cities around America after the BLM had to hire public relations experts, had to make them leaders, had to develop community programs, all of these things, community control, community view boards, and all of this stuff. Why? Because the existence of the Black Panther Party in the United States changed the paradigm to the police power of the state and the people who are subjected to that power. And I point that out to you now to bring you to full circle. Because the reason why Black political figures do not support the issue of Black political prisoners. The reason why we have political prisoners like Sekou Odinga, like Sundiata Okoli, Jaleel Muttaqin. The reason why we have political prisoners who have died in jail, who have died in exile, Sekou has just died in Zambia a few days ago. The reason why they're silent on this issue, because they profited from the betrayal of Black folks for self-determination.